Welcome to Noonday Prayers. Welcome, Brian. Welcome, Vicky. If you like Noonday Prayers, like us. And if you have prayer requests, put them in the comments. So glad to be with you. Come on. Oh, here comes Robert. Good to see you. Good to see you for Noonday Prayers.
Likewise.
Glad you're here. So we have four other people joining us here. Exciting. What a wonderful way to stop in the middle of the day to say noonday prayers together. Would you come up a little bit? There you go. Okay. So glad you're here. Noonday Prayers. Welcome. So we have about 10 minutes before we say our prayers. Just kind of be quiet. Greet us here. Welcome, Patricia. Welcome again to Noonday Prayers. We'll start in about 4 minutes. If you like Noonday Prayers, like us, and if you have prayer requests, please put them in the comments. Welcome, Mark. Welcome, Rosemary. Welcome, Vicky. Is that ready? Noonday prayers start on page 103 of the Book of Common Prayer. O God, make speed to save us.
O Lord, make haste to help us.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit,
as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Psalm 121. I lift up my eyes to the hills. From where is my help to come? My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. He will not let your foot be moved, and he who watches over you will not fall asleep. Behold, he who keeps watch over Israel shall neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord himself watches over you. The Lord is your shade at your right hand, so that the sun shall not strike you by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord shall preserve you from all evil. It is he who shall keep you safe. The Lord shall watch out over your watch over your going out and your coming in from this time forth forevermore.
Glory to the Father and to the Son. And to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
The love of God has been poured into our hearts through the Holy Spirit that has been given to us.
Thanks be to God.
From the rising of the sun to its setting, my name shall be great among the nations, and in every place incense shall be offered to my name, and a pure offering. For my name shall be great among the nations, says the Lord of hosts.
Thanks be to God. And thanks be to God to you for being with us today at the noonday hour on this Friday in October. Wanted to talk about two people whose feast days have been this week. Both of them were very instrumental in developing our English Bible. The first was William Tyndale, and he was born in 1495. in a town near the Welsh border. And he went to received his degrees from Magdalen College in Oxford, and also spent some time at Cambridge. He was very interested and determined to translate the scriptures into English. So previously, it had been in Greek or Latin. So people, the common people, people like us, couldn't read scripture. They had to go to church to hear it. But he did not get any official support in England. And so he went to Germany. And from then on, his life was a cloak and dagger story. In particular, King Henry VIII and Cardinal Wolsey and others sought to destroy his work or any translation and wanted to put him to death rather than having the English people be able to read the Bible. Finally, he was betrayed by someone that he had befriended in Brussels. And on October 6, 1536, he was strangled at the stake and then his body was burned. So it's hard to imagine that it was so hard to translate the Bible and so many people opposed it so that people could read it. He had already, by the time he died, that he had translated the New Testament and had completed the Pentateuch and also the Book of Job. But though he didn't live to see any of that published. But people say that probably 80% of his version has survived and became part of the King James Bible. One thing about Tyndale, these were his last words as he was dying. He said, "Lord, open the King of England's eyes." Wow. So really determined to have people be able to read the Bible in their own language, particularly in England. The other person is Miles Coverdale. And he was born in Yorkshire in 1488. And he studied at Cambridge and was ordained in 1514. And he completed a translation of the Bible. And it was called the Great Bible. And Archbishop Cranmer adopted a lot of his translations, in particular the Psalter that we have in our Book of Common Prayer. Is from the Coverdale Bible. Coverdale again had to go between England and the continent because people were trying to kill him and keep him from all this work. But he escaped was not martyred. He was also known as a leader in the Puritan wing of our church. So it's hard to imagine how people were trying to keep people from translating the Bible into English. Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Our Father, who Lord art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Lord, hear our prayer.
And let our cry come to you.
Let us pray.
Heavenly Father, send your Holy Spirit into our hearts to direct and rule us according to your will, to comfort us in all our afflictions, to defend us from all error, and to lead us into all truth. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen. So again, welcome to Noonday Prayers, and looking to see what prayer requests that people who joined us online. Sam is here, and welcome, Henry. Mark asked for prayers for the repose of the soul of Dr. Bruce Henderson. Rosemary C. Vicki asked for prayers for Sharon and Lou and for COP26. Mark is here. Frida, Patricia. Brian asked for prayers for his son Jacob. And Vicki. Kellogg is here. So check one more time. Make sure we don't have any new prayers. We pray for the Episcopal Church, Justin, the Archbishop of Canterbury, Michael, the presiding bishop, Larry, our bishop, and our clergy, Billy, Joanna, Michael, Patricia, Susan, and Stuart, and our staff and vestry. In the Anglican cycle of prayer, we pray for the church in Wales. In our diocese, we pray for St. Stephen's Blytheville, Calvary, Osceola, and the Executive Council, and the historiographer, Michael McNeely. We pray for peace and an end to racism, terrorism, oppression, poverty, pollution, and persecution. And on our staff, we pray for Linda Blagg, our parish secretary. We pray for our parish ministries, especially for the Sunday altar flowers. We pray for safety of first responders, healthcare workers, and those in the military, especially Megan, Sam, Marshall, and Garrett. We pray for families expecting children. We pray for all parishioners who are in need, sick, or homebound, and for those commended to our prayers. Cole, Austin, Rachel, Betsy, Craig, Tony, Mary Sue, Suzanne, Janet, Adam, Jan, Jim, Linda, Amanda, Rusty, Blake, Seal, Judy, Scott, the Owens family, Laurie, Barbara, Sean, Fernando, Billy, Becky, Lucy, Nat, I call it Nate, Lover, the Wagner family, Ellen, West, Eva, and Ron. And we give thanks for those celebrating birthdays this week. We have a huge number of people with birthdays, and for people celebrating their wedding anniversaries this week. And we pray especially for those who died, Ted Willihay and for Trudy McIntyre. Thank you again for being here with us today. Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
And thanks be to God for you. And may you have a wonderful rest of the day. And maybe we'll see you tomorrow for picking up your shrimp dinner at the shrimp bowl at St. Mark's.